The first round is over. It seems none of you managed to slay the beast. How tragic. Most of you hid in the shadows, but some of you managed to discover its weakness. But you'll have another chance tonight. I'm sure you've noticed a seat is empty tonight. Let me make this very clear. You cannot leave this game. You either win or you die. There are no exceptions. Now, draw another card.
The shaman. It says I can speak to the dead? But how?
Place your blindfolds. Round two begins now.
Do you remember what happened earlier? I saw the elevator fall, but then I saw the dawn and blacked out. I couldn't find anyone in the town, but then I swear I blinked and I was sitting at that table again. Anyway, I've been investigating here. The elevator is busted, but I found a book that might help us. It's over there on the bookstand. I left a weapon there for you too, just in case.
Thank you.
There is another way. Part of the key must be here. I'll look for it. You find the other half. Sorry, friend. I'm dead. I was looking for the key part when the beast came. It caught me out in the open. I tried to fight, but didn't stand a chance. It's up to you now. I'll help you if I still can, but in return, I want to know your story. Find the key, and you tell me more about this last love he mentioned. What do you say?
Her name was Melissa. We grew up together, and then, one day, we fell in love. It was just that simple. Like a fairy tale. It just felt so right. We got married soon after that. But it didn't last long. I lost her.
for your story. Thank you for sharing. Your story has brought me...
Me too.
Once upon a time, there was a friendly town square, always bustling with life. Until one moonlit night, a traveler came to town. He brought with him the game, and the townsfolk were mesmerized. The first round had barely begun when a beast emerged from the forest. The path was gated off, and the library lay all but abandoned. Since then, even the tavern fell silent, and no goods changed hands at the market. we'll let you in.
First, the game seemed like a magical adventure. I burned my hand assembling the seal, but things became serious by the second round. I fell and lost a shoe while running through. I barely survived the third round, but not without a claw mark. The true horror came during the fourth round. That was when my heart stopped, freezing me in this in-between state.
I was so close to slaying the beast, but dawn broke just before I could strike the blow. Round two was over. I knew it would be harder to get the Beast Slayer card without drawing the beast's attention. There were fewer players now, making me a bigger target for the beast, but I had to keep playing. For Melissa,